You should be able to move back there in a few days.
Should I? I don't think I feel comfortable after everything that's happened.
Well, I realise it must be difficult, but we've gathered all the evidence we can from the house.
Did that tell you what happened?
Maybe. There are a few things that don't add up. Are you sure you heard a telephone?
Yeah, I think so.
And it's this call that delayed your trip? I know it's hard to think back, but it's important we get to the facts. You do understand. Look, I'll call round later and we'll see if we can figure it out between us.
Okay.
Where have you been?
Belle wanted to feed Hamish.
Again? Hay doesn't grow on trees, you know.
I know, it grows in fields. All right. There we go.
Let's see if my dad's moved another inch on map.
What are you doing with my dad's penknife?
Well, what's he got to do with you?
He might have needed that.
Tough.
Well, what if he gets stuck in the jungle?
Yeah, well, then have you to blame then, won't he?
Hey, don't take it out on Sam.
Why not? It was him who put the stupid idea in my dad's head in the first place.
At least Dad didn't nick his penknife.
Yeah, well, he gave me this, you daft get. You know, and I'm glad he did, because right now I could just stick...
Hey, that's enough! Now leave him alone. It's not his fault.
Yeah, well, if he'd have kept his nose out in the first place...
Did you hear what I said? Leave him alone, or you'll have me to answer to.
You know it's his fault as well as I do.
Oh, it's like a cemetery in here.
Well, we do have a lot of spirits.
As I recall, there was talk of giving up bad jokes for New Year.
Oh, yeah, but I didn't actually make a resolution. Hey, come on, that wasn't a bad joke.
I liked it.
See, I'm keeping the customers happy.
No, when your jokes are turning beer sour, you're not. Mm. Better top that up, Wolf.
Oh, it's bright resolutions, me. I started belly dancing once, but I couldn't keep the ruby in.
I gave up Rodney 1 year. I've stuck to that.
It's not what I remember.
Resolutions, how about you then, Marlon? Planning a new fitness campaign, tone up that physique.
You're joking, ain't ya? Marlon ain't got no willpower.
Ooh, there's a challenge if ever I heard one.
Yeah? Well, I'll do it if you will.
I'll think about it.
Don't wait too long. That's how things got out of hand in Paris.
What?
The French Resolution.
Oh. If I had a pound for every bad joke,
you'd be a rich woman.
Rich? You're forgetting my marriage to Rodney. That alone would buy me a small island in the Pacific. Oh, listen to me prattling on. How are you?
You know.
No, I don't. You won't tell me.
Well, I thought I might just take Bolin out for a walk.
Again? That's the third time today. I know why you're doing this. I'm not daft.
Aren't you?
You think caring for Bolin will somehow keep Ray alive? I know it's hard. But it's not your fault. You know that, don't you? Good. So how about we walk this pooch together? Save me having to face any more of Bob's jokes.
Oh, well...
I'd love to, really. We don't have to talk. I just want you to know I'm there. I've got a pair of sensible shoes somewhere that Alan bought me.
OK, I'll do it. I want to stop biting my nails.
Oh, it's something, I suppose.
Oh, you're joking. Nail biting, that's up there with the big boys. You're going to have to come up with something good in return.
Well, I haven't got many bad habits.
Well, let me think. Sharp tongue.
That's not true. Is it, Brian?
Yeah, well, you can be a bit harsh.
Yeah? Well, you can be a bit boring, but I ain't complaining.
Then there's your timekeeping, your chocolate habit, not to mention your shopping addiction.
Shopping addiction?
Oh, really? Then you won't mind giving it up then, will you? No?
Oh, it's turned cold again. I'll just go once around the cricket field and back.
Oh, thank goodness for that, I can't feel my face.
You don't have to come if you don't want. I said I'd walk with you.
There's a nice warm pub back there, you know.
Just having a fag.
Like I say, warm pub, big ashtrays. Come on, let's leave him to it before my nose drops off. I saw that look, you know.
What look?
Them daggers you were throwing at Terry.
Was I?
I think it's about time you and he buried the hatchet, don't you?
You want to be careful.
If they keep on practising...
Oh, rubbish! You haven't seen them. Len's hardly a natural mover. Now me and Bob have got that competition in the bag.
It don't do to be too confident with bags. I work with them every day. They sometimes split to reveal the most unusual contents.
Just these, please.
Any news on Zach?
Sam tells me he's got some business.
Oh, that's right, to do with his father's estate.
Overseas, I heard.
Yeah, his dad were an explorer.
Are you sure he hasn't just up sticks and walked out? Only men get a bit funny round about Zach's days, especially what with, you know.
He's away on business and that's all there is to it, so... Now, do you want paying for these? Or are they free with every third degree?
I think you've hit a nerve there, ladies.
Well, it's obvious, isn't it? He's left her.
So, these phone calls. In your statement, you mention Mr. Mullen received a call on the morning he died. How do you explain that?
I don't know. Another mobile, maybe?
There are no other numbers registered in Mr. Mullen's name.
Well, Ray had a lot of businesses. Maybe he used one for certain calls.
What do you know of his business dealings?
Not much. Ray kept his work very private.
And what about the harassment you've been suffering? Has that continued?
No.
I'm simply trying to figure out if anyone might have had a motive to kill Ray. There might be a connection.
Well, I can't believe anyone would want to kill him.
Can't hear anything.
I hope they're not upset now.
Hey, why did the policeman cross the road?
What's going on?
Team chat over?
For now. I think she could do with some company.
What were all that about?
They've been questioning Louise.
Again? Is she all right?
Why don't you swallow your pride and come and find out?
I found this bloke in the bar, trying to hide his concern.
Maybe this wasn't such a good idea after all.
Oh, be quiet and sit down. Are you all right, pet? Good, because I know Terry's bothered, even though he doesn't want to admit it. Oh, look at us. The atmosphere's frostier in here than it is outside. Doesn't seem 5 minutes since we all lived here like one big happy family.
Yeah, until one of us weren't welcome anymore.
We might not be living under the same roof now, but this is a small village and it doesn't take much to spoil the mood. Now, I don't know about you, but I'd like to bring some friendship back into it.
She's right.
Sorry, Terry.
Yeah, me and all. I could have made it easy for you.
Good. We'll call that a start then, shall we?
Well, oh, there's Snowy. And there's Tintin.
Daddy.
Hey, Belle thinks Captain Haddock's my dad.
He is a flipping Haddock.
Where do you reckon he'll be by now?
Nowhere he's supposed to be, that's for sure.
Sorry. Come on, Belle. Let's do some more reading upstairs.
Pressure getting to your ready, is it?
And I could do without your snide remarks.
Well, I can't handle the truth.
What's that, Mr. Smart Aleck?
That you let him go. You and Dumbo up there.
Don't you dare. At least I tried to make him stay, which is more than you ever did.
Well, how do you know what I did? You weren't even there. You didn't hear him telling me how he'd be glad to see the back of you.
You're lying. He had the measure of you from day one. He knew exactly what sort of scheming lowlife he'd produced.
That's enough.
You're the product of some drunken fumble. You're never a proper son.
I said enough.
Don't like it when a woman stands up to you, eh? Is that why Letitia left? Or Angie?
Shut it!
Or what? Don't think you can bully me now, Zach's gone. I think you'll find I'm not as soft as the others.
think it's really romantic going on a quest to seek your fortune.
I wish Nicola would do a moonlight. She's becoming a real pain in the backside.
There's creams for that, you know.
Yes, but do they come in industrial strength?
It's genetic. You don't have to look at the mother. Staff's gear don't come cheap.
I know what he's on about. My missus bled me dry before she ran off.
What the money I've spent on haute couture could retire.
But the resolution?
Ain't made to be broken.
Mm. Not this time.
No prizes for guessing what you're talking about. Hard to get between a girl and her retail therapy.
You know, the way to a man's heart is a different route altogether.
I don't see them beating a path to your door.
Enough for three, is there?
No. Because you're going to find some sad mug to buy your drink in the wall pack.
I would, but your dad's busy tonight.
Well, I've got plans. And they don't involve you playing gooseberry.
Right, all right. Keep your hair on. I'll leave you on your own. But you better make the best of it, girl. He won't be hanging around for long.
She pulled a knife, fine. I'll give her that.
All right. Better than some I could mention.
It's a talent, that. Wish I had it. My sister Caroline, she's got it. She used to work behind the bar at this swanky hotel in York. People used to travel miles to see her shake a martini. What you up to?
Have you seen the colour of her? I'm not looking insipid in front of my bob.
Look, we'd better be offset, lad. You know, it took me ages to persuade Edna I'm not after her body.
Bob and me will be along later. We don't need as much practice as Sam.
Time I left and all, I want to see if Sam's all right.
Well, don't forget to let me know.
It's chilly. Chilly? I'm absolutely freezing.
Okay, it's a joke. Here's a pint.
Go and sort him out. I don't want any trouble.
Huh? Oh. Kane? Everything all right? I heard about Uncle Zach. How's Lisa?
Poor lad. Must have hit him hard. Still, bad ones must have feelings as well, I suppose. Mm.
No more for me. I'm stuffed.
Oh, nonsense. After I've gone to all this trouble. I've got my favourite film.
9.5 weeks.
Oh, Dirty Dancing. I love it. Nobody puts baby in a corner. Oh, so romantic. Mind you, that bit with Mickey Rourke in the fridge does something to me as well.
Yes, my account number's 6290. How much? Yeah, okay.
Ha! Caught you! Oh, yes!
Were you playing at?
We had a deal. No shopping, remember?
I wasn't shopping.
Oh, no. How much? No, that's okay.
I was checking my bank balance, you idiot. What's the matter? Don't you trust me or something? Oh. And they look shorter than they did earlier. People in glass houses shouldn't throw stones, Marlon.
Music maestro, please.
It's what mood that worries me.
Let's show these OAPs how to really dance.
Ah! Oh!
Do you think my dad going with my fault or not? I wish I'd never bothered with that deposit box now. All the trouble it's caused.
Oh, Sam, you mustn't think that. Kane's just been his usual messed up self, and me, well, I just miss the silly old fool. Why don't you go off to the pub? Cheer yourself up a bit.
Don't seem right without me, Dad.
Well, I'll go with you, love, but someone's got to stop here and look after Belle.
Hiya! Just thought I'd pop in. See how you are.
That's nice.
I thought you'd be down the pub.
No one to go away. Lacey's got to look after Belle.
Well, you go with Laurel, I don't mind.
It's not the same. Should be a family thing.
Something deeply satisfying about the look on Viv Hope's face at this minute. I wish you'd stop mumbling. What did you say?
Knickers in bra. Knickers in.
Oh! I might have known. Here I was giving you the benefit of the doubt, and all the time your filthy mind was working overtime.
Edna! I can explain.
Oh, don't you bother. You're as bad as that, Sid. Well, you will not be using me for any more of your cheap thrills.
Well, let's hope that doesn't happen in the competition. Well, that's it for dancing. I'll see you in the pub when one of you is fit enough to buy me a drink.
Oh, I think it's dead exciting.
Me and Al. Feels weird without my dad, though. I keep thinking he's going to creep in and surprise us. Like we're all a joke.
Tell you what, why don't I babysit for a while and you two go and have a drink together?
I don't think so, but thanks all the same.
But you said if we found someone to look after Belle, you'd take me.
Yeah, well, that were then.
Well, what's wrong with now?
Well, maybe Lisa's tired. Christmas is enough to take it out of anybody, and last thing you need sometimes is a buffer of people.
Especially them that are too concerned with idle gossip.
Yeah, well, I don't mind. I'm proud of what my dad's doing.
There's no one in the pub you can't handle, Lisa.
Well, maybe I could manage one.
Great. 9 o'clock. That's a tenner for me.
Have you been betting on what Neil will get up to with Nicola? Typical man.
No. I just bet he won't escape before 9.
Good to see you, Lisa.
Oh, come and join us. The night gets better and better.
Ignore them, Sam. We'll just get a drink and sit down somewhere quiet.
Lisa, I was just asking Kane how you were.
Oh, and what did he have to say?
Well, nothing. Just sits there staring.
Oh, well, maybe his conscience is pricking him at last. Well, of the usual, Marlon.
There's a few more fish in the river now that husband of yours has gone.
I'm sorry.
Well, I'm not. He caused me nothing but grief.
Hey, that's my dad you're talking about.
What kind of a dad walks out on his family? Never had Zach Dingle down as a coward.
Oi.
Don't make this harder than it already is.
Look, when you have the bottle to leave everything you love behind and risk everything for your family, then you can say something. And that goes for you lot and all. Not one of you have got the guts to do what he's done. So until you do, I suggest you all be quiet. All right? Come on, I got us a seat over here.
I'd have thought you'd stopped eating by now.
What are you doing here?
I live here, remember?
How could I forget?
Busy night in Woolpack.
Oh, I'll say. It nearly kicked off between Kane Dingle and that Brian geezer. Oh, and Sid said you owe him a tenner.
It sounds riveting. I'm surprised you could drag yourself away.
Oh, you know me, Nickers. I need my beauty sleep.
Not at all. You're a very attractive woman.
Why, thank you, Neil. I should remember you said that. However, it does take a lot more work these days.
Well, don't let us stop you. I mean, if you don't make a start now, you'll never get the filler out before midnight.
Nicola?
Don't worry, Neil, you'll get used to it.
You've done this on purpose. Just because you can't get a man of your own?
I better be going.
No, don't. We can go to my room.
Like I said before, early start.
You said you looked on Brian's face when he thought you were going to clout him.
Oh, no, it was Viv's mouth. She looked like that chow we had last week.
Ah, did you have a nice time?
Oh, the best. But except if my dad were there.
Right, I better be going. I've got to be up for my run in the morning.
Oh, Sam will walk you home, won't you, love?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Oh, no, thank you.
Come on, you.
Right. I think I'll turn in.
Kane, thanks for what you did. It meant something.
Yeah, it's all right.